I've been kind of on a little, you know, ride lately of making videos about creativity, especially under open source and Linux. This one's gonna be a little different because this one isn't exclusive to Linux. This is the power of the web, bringing people to collaborate. And this one also can kind of tap in the realm of things like coding. And I know I said like creativeness things under Linux, and you know, in a lot of ways, coding is a creative format. You are creating things. You are building things. Sometimes you're coding for businesses or whatever, but there's a lot of people who make programs and code just to scratch that little personal itch. This can be used for that. But realistically, this is about writing documents and documents collaboratively over the web. Does this mean we're getting rid of Vim? Just the opposite. We're still going the course. I've been a longtime proponent of using Markdown format for document handling. It does a lot of the bare-bone functions that most people need when it comes to document writing. And personally, I always felt like it was kind of weird to load up a multi-hundred megabyte program just to basically write down text. Now, the truth is, a word processor like LibreOffice or Microsoft Office, those are very powerful pieces of software that can design a lot of beautiful documents, but they're always designed with the idea that these are to be printed. And there's so many documents that we write on our computers that were designed to stay on the computer. It's always going to be digital. It's never going to be a print. And if it's just raw data, it kind of makes a lot of sense to go with Markdown. Now, there's a lot of people who like Markdown. They're probably thinking, yes, we know this, a Godoy. But it can be a little limiting when you need to collaborate. Now, here I have a document that I generated. It's sitting in Vim, and I have it in my focus mode that I like with some of my fun little Vim plugins. But at the end of the day, this is just a Markdown document. So when I need to collaborate, I could copy the contents of this document and open up Google Docs, or Microsoft Office Online, or even Nextcloud. And those are all awesome programs, but maybe you don't want to put your document on another gargantuan platform with a massive footprint. Maybe you just want to shoot a link to somebody and be like, hey, let's work on this together. And there's a program that does this fairly good and kind of pseudo-anonymously. Etherpad. Now, Etherpad's been around for a while, and it is designed just to do that one thing and one thing well. Collaborative editing real time. And the nice thing about Etherpad is it's free, it's open source, it has a relatively small footprint. So small, in fact, that you scroll down here to the list of public instances, and this is where people are running pseudo-anonymous Etherpads. And if you look at here, one of them is actually Wikimedia's own build of Etherpad. Super fast. Beautiful, right? There's a bunch of them on here. Some of these are a little outdated. Some of these have features added to them that aren't in the default open source platform. Some of them are kind of themed or skinned, but they all kind of have the same thing in common, providing they're open to the public, that they are a collaborative tool that you can hop on, start editing a document, and share that document. So I kind of started doing that. I don't know if you can see from the tab here, it's my regular user, and I have another user in Firefox using containers. So I'm going to go to the document, and here I'm using the riseup.net Etherpad. Now, riseup.net is a nonprofit organization. They have a lot of privacy-centric tools that are online for anyone to use. And if you look over here, there's two users of this document. Now, on this tab, I'm Art. That's me. And on this other tab, I made the user not Art. And I wanted to kind of show that in these two tabs, this is the real-time collaborative. Now, just because I'm on the same machine doesn't matter. The other tab could be a computer across the world. It's going to work the same way. It's real-time collaborative editing. And if you notice, everything's color coded. So art is in this blue greenish highlight, and not art, all the edits he makes are in the yellow. And that's a good portion of how it works. There's also a little chat function, which is nice. So you can have little conversations while you work together, though admittedly a phone call or another tab running like Jitsi or Discord or whatever you like is a good option also. I would definitely lean more towards things like Jitsi that are, again, similar to this, very little footprint with big benefits. So you could basically copy the document from Vim, NeoVim, VS Code, wherever you're working, paste it in here, send the link to your buddy, you and them, get together, collaborate, make your changes. You have a history of what was happening. There's the undo and the redos and all that kind of stuff. So if we look at this time slider, you can see the history of the document as it's changing. And every time you type, it saves a new version. Very cool, right? So let's go back out of that real quick. Can I get out of that? I'm sure there's a way. Oh, return it back. There it is. A lot of features here. You have the chat feature. You have that. Line numbers over here are very important, especially if you're, because you can do code on this. You can do real-time coding, which probably not the tool designed for this unless you're trying to debug something in real time. Git is still one of the best for that more glacial collaborative editing. Side note, this is a tiny little side one, but a lot of people sleep on the fact that you can use Git for collaborative creative writing, because text, code is text, narratives are text, documents are text. Markdown gives you formatting, but you don't need to use formatting. It can all just be plain text. That's fine too, as long as the information is connected. And if you refer to my last video with the found format, you can even do narrative writing in the form of comic book, stage, or film scripts. And this could be collaborated too in the same exact way using Etherpad. Now, Etherpad also has a strange location. This is a little another side, and that is EtherCalc. EtherCalc is very similar. Oh, that is not what I wanted. EtherCalc. I don't know what that was. There we go. EtherCalc.net. Oh, this one's down right now. Oh, very unfortunate. There's probably another. Yeah, here we are. Here's another instance. Again, open source, create a spreadsheet, Bob's your uncle, the same kind of thing. You copy from, well, I guess you'd be copying from your spreadsheet or your spreadsheet improved if you're a command line junkie, and you could paste your content in here, collaboratively edit your spreadsheet in here, and then take it back out. Not as slick in my mind as the other one. Links for all these will, of course, be down below. But yes, collaborative editing is that kind of thing that anyone can just take advantage of this. Oh, and when you generate documents, depending on the server, the RiseUp one gave me the option of having this document automatically delete itself from the internet in one day. So 24 hours after I record this video, and I stop editing it, that is, this document disappears. So I will not be linking the document. You can try to figure out the link here, but chances are it'll be gone by the time you see this video. And there's nothing wrong with that. This is something that can be applied in multiple ways, and probably in ways I haven't even fathomed yet. I haven't looked into what it takes to set an instance up. It seems like it's probably pretty straightforward. I would not be surprised if someone has a turnkey Docker ready to go, but I'll link to both the Etherpad website, some of the examples I have down below, as well as the full Git repo for the open source project, and you can check that out below. Hope you enjoyed this video. I got more stuff coming, I'm trying to up my video game this year, my video production game this year. And my goal is to have at least 50 videos out this year, close to one a week with a little bit of wiggle room. That's the goal. So if you want to see more, there is more coming. Feel free to subscribe, like, and all that good stuff. And I'll catch you soon. Baby, your time is up.